What is going on, everybody, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I want to talk about your diet and more specifically how you can actually stick to your diet or your nutrition plan. Personally, I just want to clarify that I don't really like the word diet even though I used it because normally that means more of a short-term approach, and we do all know that nutrition is definitely something that you need to be able to sustain for the long term. It's something that you need to kind of implement and make it a lifestyle, and I guarantee that if you do that, your goals will be that much easier to achieve. So before we jump into today's video, I'd really appreciate if you guys could hit that subscribe button, especially if you're new to my channel. I do upload consistently and I do put out a lot of great content, so make sure to hit that subscribe button. Like I mentioned, the focus of today's video is going to be on diet. I'm going to be giving you my 5 best tips on actually how to stick with your nutrition and stop cheating on your diet. Starting off with my first tip, and that's going to be meal prepping. I honestly think this is absolutely essential and it's a must for everybody to do because we do all live busy lifestyles, and there's going to be times where something comes up where you can't get a meal in, or you're going to the vending machine, or you're kind of maybe you're limited to your 1 hour lunch at work, and you're spending most of your time waiting in like a drive-through or maybe like a lineup at a restaurant to get some food. By just bringing your lunch, you're going to ensure that you're not having those nutritional inconsistencies in your diet, plus you're saving that time that you would normally take. So you actually be able to extend your lunch and not have to wait in those 15 to 20 minute lines, because we are very limited with, especially like I said, if you do work a 9-to-5 job and you do get that hour for lunch, I guarantee that if you start bringing your lunch, it's going to be absolutely a game changer. But in terms of meal prepping, I think it's absolutely essential for a couple reasons. The first is because you're really ensuring that what you're preparing for the week is going to align to your nutritional goals. And most times when we make bad nutritional choices, it's because we're hungry, we're in a rush, and we don't really feel like cooking up the food. So I think that by having it all proportioned and planned and weighed out in advance, you're not going to have to do that during the week. And all you have to do is really add it to your FitnessPal or whatever tracking app you use. And therefore, you can just kind of grab and go, and you know that you're not going to you're going to be reducing those urges to want to cheat on your diet. And the less opportunity you give yourself during the week, the better choices you're going to make. So I think that meal prepping is an absolute must. So just a couple tips on how I meal prep. Most people think of meal prepping, they think about doing maybe 7 days, 6 days. They think about the week. Honestly, what I like to do is I like to meal prep maybe 2 or 3 times a week. And what I do, the reason why I do that is because I normally meal prep for like 2 days. I find the food tastes a lot better, and you basically have the option of switching out your protein sources and your carbs. So let's say on Sunday night, you kind of prepare your chicken and your rice, and then maybe by Wednesday, you're not really feeling like chicken and rice anymore because you've ate 2 or 3 days of it. It gives you the option to kind of switch out food options. Plus, it allows you to kind of eat fresh every 3 days, which is also nice. So what I would do is I would kind of meal prep every Sunday and every Wednesday. And therefore, you're kind of not having a bunch of food prepared that you might not want to eat. And like I said, it gives you that variety. So I highly encourage you guys to definitely give meal prepping. And the reason why it's going to actually stop you from cheating on your diet is because, like I mentioned before, normally we're in a rush and we come home and we're extremely hungry. We find ourselves going into the snacks, the chips, and we're kind of eating those things while we're cooking our meals because we're so hungry and we don't really have the patience to wait to kind of cook the food. So I think that by having those meals prepared, you're not going to be able to, you're not going to have the opportunity to do that because there's absolutely no excuses why you can't grab something out of the fridge and reheat it up. And like I mentioned before, it's perfect for those who live a busy lifestyle, who work maybe 9-to-5 or just maybe work maybe 8 hours a day. You have a lot more, you have a lot less chance of actually skipping out and going to restaurants because you took the time to actually prepare your meals. Now moving on to my second tip, and that's going to be finding zero calorie or low calorie substitutes. I think the biggest one here is condiments. I think a lot of people use salad dressings and they use barbecue sauces and ketchups. And what ends up happening is they end up not really thinking that they need to track it, and ends up kind of just putting way too much on. And that's a couple hundred calories that you might be going over every day. So how this is going to actually impact it is that you might think the scale should be going down because you think that you're following your nutrition, but little did you track those sauces and those condiments that you actually used. And like I said, that can make a big difference, a couple hundred calories a day. And then, like I said, instead of the scale going down like you think it should, it's going up. And this could really discourage you from your diet. Maybe you think that it's not working. And then you kind of just go back to your old ways. So I think that in terms of using those condiments, if you are, there's tons of different substitutes out there. So just a couple that I'd like to mention just to kind of give you guys some ideas. I really like salsa. If you kind of use a lot of ketchup, I know there's lower calorie ketchups as well, but salsa is a really great one to kind of start implementing in your diet. And it's going to come at a much lower calorie. It's going to be a lot less calories than what you could potentially be using instead. Another thing that I like is mustards. I just find that there's so many different flavors of mustard. You can get Dijon, there's also sweet with heat, which I really like. And then there's ground mustard or stone ground mustard. So there's tons of different, and then there's your classic yellow mustard as well. And honestly, I think that it adds a lot to your food. And just if you put it on, I know it kind of sounds weird, but if you put it on chicken, I think it really goes good. If you make, one thing that I do a lot is I make the extra lean ground chicken and turkey patties, and I find that it goes really well on those. But yeah, if you're not a mustard fan and you've always got hot sauce, and I think there also is low calorie barbecue sauce. So I think just by making that slight switch, you're gonna be able to kind of allow, see the scale go down more, you're gonna have more options, you're gonna get less discouraged when you actually think that you're kind of eating plain food. And I think a lot of people are under the false impression that they can't eat good in order to kind of lose weight. And it's all about, just like I said, finding those substitutes, finding things that you're able to implement in your diet. So for snacks like popcorn, you can still enjoy popcorn, but what I would recommend is going with a smarter option like Smart Pop. If you start eating that, it's lower in calories than your regular popcorn, but yet you still get to enjoy popcorn. So I think that it all comes down to making smarter decisions and finding low calorie substitutes that you're able to fit into your nutrition that aren't adding a bunch of calories in. And ultimately, you're gonna be seeing the scale go down and you're not gonna be getting discouraged and you're not gonna be able to kind of get the impression that you wanna give up in your diet because it's not working. So I highly encourage you guys to definitely try out some mustard, try out some hot sauce. Just kind of try to find low calorie substitutes to kind of add to your food. And I guarantee that you'll enjoy what you're eating a lot more and you'll actually achieve your weight loss goals at the same time. Moving on to the third tip, and that's the easiest and most basic on the list, and that's actually get to bed early. A lot of us struggle with late night snacking, and all those calories can add up, especially when you kind of want to put on your favorite TV show and relax and eat some junk food. I think that's a lot more tempting in the evening because we kind of want to, we're bored, we're looking for things to do, we're not running around all day like we were when we were working or we were doing things during the day, and you finally get a chance to sit down and relax, and this is where those hunger hormones really kick in, and you really are looking for snacks. So like I mentioned, getting to bed early is really, really important from a couple of perspectives. The first is that obviously when you're sleeping, you can't be eating. So that's gonna eliminate that altogether. But the second thing is that you're actually, by getting to bed early, you're obviously gonna increase your amount of sleep that you get. You're gonna be getting that 8 to 9 hours and you're gonna be waking up in the morning feeling refreshed. And actually good sleep or having proper sleep on a consistent basis is gonna lead to a lot less hunger hormones during the day. So eventually, if you do consistently get enough sleep, you're gonna be eliminating those hunger hormones altogether. So a couple tips with this is that if you do find that you're watching TV in your living room and it's close to the kitchen, try maybe finding a spot in your house that's kind of further away from the kitchen if you wanna spend your time, and you'll be less likely to kind of wander off in the kitchen while there's a commercial break, or maybe you just kind of get distracted for a moment and then your mind goes to food. I think that the closer you are to the kitchen in your home, obviously the easier it is to snack. Maybe you don't want to go to bed that early. I would recommend just kind of going in your bedroom and maybe finishing watching the TV show in bed. Because like I said, you are far less likely to kind of get out of bed, put some clothes on, and then go to the kitchen and cook whatever you're cooking. So I think that just eliminating that is definitely going to help improve and really kind of reduce that late night snacking. And I do like to allocate some of my calories. So maybe if you find yourself, you find like you're good during the day, but you also find, like I mentioned, you get that late night snacking in the evening. Maybe budget some or save some of your calories for the evening. I personally like to have some popcorn in the evening, some Greek yogurt, and I have something before I go to bed as well. So a lot of my calories are kind of in the evening, but like in terms of weight loss, your main goal is to stay in that calorie deficit. So as long as you're eating under the daily amount of calories that you actually burn, then you're obviously gonna lose weight. So I think that no matter how you eat, as long as, like I said, you're eating that deficit, you're gonna be okay. But all those late night snacks can definitely add up, and they can add up quick. And next thing you know, you're completely off the rails with your nutrition. And going back to what I mentioned before with the substitutes, I think that if you find those substitutes, if you have Smart Pop instead of popcorn, maybe you have some rice cakes instead of chips, you're gonna be able to limit those calories to a lot less than you would if you were to kind of eat a full bag of chips or maybe some ice cream. So I think that like going back kind of ties into finding those substitutes. But yeah, I highly encourage you guys, if you can find yourself getting those late night snacking hormones around 8 p.m., maybe set your bedtime for 9 and kind of get ready to bed. If you kind of put your mindset that you're getting ready for bed, you're gonna be able to shift your focus from food to bed, and you're gonna be able to actually reduce those late night cravings. And that's gonna ultimately allow you to stop cheating and actually stick to your diet. Now my fourth tip for helping you sustain your diet and stick to your nutrition is gonna kind of sound odd, and that's actually having a planned cheat meal. I think a lot of people take that the wrong way. And honestly, you have to make sure that it's planned. I think that word really matters in that sentence. The reason being is because if you don't plan it in advance, then it can easily get off the rails and you can end up finding yourself having some wings, some nachos, some beer, or whatever you want to have for that cheat meal. I think by planning it and kind of thinking like, what do you really want? What would really be satisfying? I think you're able to kind of control it a lot better, and you're also allowed to budget it through the week. So let's say, for example, you want to have your cheat meal on Saturday. You know that day is where you're going to be able to order those wings, you're going to be able to have some pizza, and it's also going to help from a weight loss standpoint as well, because like I said, you're going to feel more satisfied in terms of your nutrition. You're not going to feel as limited because you do know you have that opportunity during the week, and as long as you are in a deficit during the week, I think that's another thing that it's important to mention. As long as you are in a deficit during the week, you don't need to be in a deficit every single day. I think it's the week that you need to really make sure that you are in that deficit. And if you are, you're going to lose weight that week. So I think that making sure that you have a planned cheat meal is extremely important. Another thing I'd like to mention about the cheat meal and planning it is that if you do plan it, then you know that you are only going to be cheating for one meal. And I think people take that to the extreme and they end up having a cheat day or even a cheat week. And that's something you definitely don't want. So by actually planning that, you're going to have that day scheduled. So let's just to give you an example how you could easily lose track. Let's say you had a cheat meal on maybe on Tuesday, and then Saturday rolls around and you're like, okay, well, I want to go out, there's things going on, I want to kind of go out and have a meal. But if you didn't kind of plan that cheat meal in advance, it's easy to say, you know what, I'm going to have that cheat meal on Saturday, and then you end up having two that week, and then you don't really get one the next week. So I think that having a plan in place and kind of thinking about your schedule ahead of time and thinking that maybe your coworkers are getting together, or maybe you have friends and family that want to go out for a birthday, I think that planning in advance, really scheduling that cheat meal, really gives you some social freedom, allows you to kind of stick to your diet well, also enjoying the times with family and friends and the meals out. So I think that's another very important thing from a cheat meal perspective. And in terms of fitting it in your nutrition, I think there's tons of ways to do that. You can easily cut into some of your carbs. Let's say you're having pizza, for example. You know that pizza is high in carbs, you know that it's high in fat because of the cheese. So what you can do is you can plan that during your day and kind of reduce some of the fatty foods that are found in your nutrition that day, and also reduce some of the carbs, so then you're able to fit that in. So I think that planning your cheat meal is extremely important, and I think a lot of people get that wrong when they think that they can have whatever they want. I would kind of keep it, I would definitely keep it under 1,000 calories in terms of your cheat meal, and don't kind of be scared to eat during the day. I think that's another mistake that people make, is that they go really, really low on their calories that day, and they just have their cheat meal. That's not going to be beneficial from a weight loss standpoint, so make sure you budget your cheat meal, make sure you plan it in advance. And now for my fifth tip, which really should have been the first one on the list, and that's actually to remove all the junk food or snack items from your home. This one can be extremely difficult if you aren't living alone, but if you are living at home, maybe you're living with you and your girlfriend or your wife, and you kind of, it's just two of you, it's much easier to kind of eliminate that. But if you do kind of have kids, then it can be definitely difficult. I can understand that, because everybody is not necessarily on your nutrition plan. Everybody eats differently. So if you do throw out all the potato chips or all the snacks, it's obviously not gonna work for everybody else, and everybody else wants to have their own snacks. And you do follow, like I said, everyone follows a different nutrition. Maybe your family is definitely not on the plan that you're on. But I think that if you kind of get rid of the snacks, if you do live alone, then you're gonna be much better off. Don't buy potato chips, don't buy chocolate, don't buy candy. Just really stick to the foundations, and really don't go to the grocery store when you're hungry. You hear that all the time. But that's normally when you do buy those snacks, is when you're hungry and you go to the grocery store, you buy everything you want for your diet, but you also tack on all those potato chips and sugary items. So I think that if you do live alone, definitely don't buy those things. And if you do have them, definitely get rid of them. It can be hard throwing that out because it is money, but I guarantee you'll be much better off. And if you do get those urges to cheat, you won't have those items available, and you'll be far less likely to go to the store, the grocery store, late at night to kind of pick them up. But if you do live with family and friends, what I would recommend is having a separate pantry, or having a separate spot for your food versus somebody else's food. I know this is gonna kind of sound silly, but honestly, sometimes when you're just out of boredom, you walk to the kitchen, you open up your fridge, or you open up your pantry and you look in, and the first thing you see is like a chocolate bar or a bag of chips. It's far more likely to kind of like make yourself feel hungry when you're not. You're like, oh, I'm just gonna have a couple chips out of this. I think that if you kind of place that somewhere else and maybe put it back further in the pantry and put something a little bit healthier, like some popcorn, in front of that, I think you're more likely to see that, and you're kind of able to kind of convince yourself that you don't need it, and you're gonna be a lot less likely to kind of want to cheat on your diet. So I think that, like I said, it should have been on the first one on the list, but if you kind of notice that you do have a lot of junk food around, just kind of throw it out and get rid of it, because you don't want to have those urges. And the less opportunities that you give yourself, the less chances you are going to actually be able to cheat on your diet. So that would be my fifth tip. Really get rid of all the junk food. And if you do have junk food and you live with other people, like I mentioned, separate it and kind of devote something to you, and just kind of eliminate your chances of actually seeing it and being able to access it. Alright guys, so there you have it, my five best tips for actually how to sustain and stick with your nutrition. Like I mentioned at the start of the video, it is a consistent effort, and over time, as long as you are in a deficit, you are going to lose weight. But I think that the biggest thing is to find things that work for you. Take one of these tips. If you find yourself struggling in one area, then definitely try out one of these tips. It might not apply to everybody, but in terms of the late night snacking, if you do find that you do that, then try to get to bed earlier. Maybe you find that you do use a lot of salad dressing, then definitely try to find some lower calorie substitutes. So I hope everybody found this video useful and got something out of it, and I hope everybody, I hope I improved everybody's chance of actually sticking with their diet. And if you do use these, then definitely leave it in the comments and let me know how you found it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because I have a lot of great content that's planned in the works and I'm super excited to deliver to you guys, so make sure to hit that subscribe button. Also turn on the bell notifications. I do release videos 3 times a week, and I want to make sure you guys get notified every time I upload. For those who are new, I upload every Sunday, every Wednesday, and every Friday, so be sure to turn those bell notifications to get notified, and also drop the video a like. I do appreciate all the support, and the feedback goes a long way, and I'll see everybody in the next one. Alright, peace out.